loves, it's your girl Liz from PretaProgress23. Welcome back to the Acne channel. It's been such a long time since I've posted on here, but I really wanted to update you guys on my microneedling experience. It's been 2 years since I've used microneedling tools to treat my acne scars. So just a little bit of my story. I used to have severe cystic acne all over my cheeks, and I was left completely defeated when I just saw the scars on my face. It was not until I started treating my skin with microneedling tools that I realized that I could improve the appearance, and that all came down to this. Ta-da! So these are 0.5 millimeters, and this really, really helps your skin produce collagen, because as we grow older, we lose our collagen production. So with microneedling, it has so many different benefits. By increasing that collagen, we treat our acne scars, we treat our wrinkles, and the plumpness of our skin. It also increases product absorption. And when I heard all of these amazing benefits when it came to microneedling, I rushed into the process, and I made many, many, many mistakes, and I slowed down my own progress. So first things first. Mistake number one is stamping on problematic areas. Now it's a given that you don't stamp on active acne, because when you're stamping on active acne, you are putting the microneedles into your pustules and then you're spreading the bacteria. You don't want that. But a lot of the time people get confused with active acne and also blackheads. While blackheads are not active acne, it's still a problematic area. So you don't really want to stamp over blackheads or whiteheads or clogged pores. You only want to treat where your scars are. If you do have active acne, you just want to stamp around the area. Mistake number two is applying way too much pressure. There's this misconception that the harder you press, the better results you get. All this is doing is irritating your skin and prolonging the recovery time. I remember when I first started out, you know, like I saw the vampire microneedling sessions in clinics, the Kim Kardashian microneedling, and I was like, yep, I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna have really good results. So then I was like stamping, stamping, stamping. My skin was bleeding and I worsened my acne. You are not meant to bleed, girl. Like, the needles are 0.5 millimeters for a reason. You're not meant to penetrate your skin deeper than the needles are meant to go. So please be wary of the pressure that you apply. It's meant to be moderate, it's not meant to hurt, and you're not meant to bleed. Well, if you bleed a little bit, that's fine, but if you're aggressively bleeding, please stop, because it's causing more damage to your skin. Mistake number three is using the wrong skincare right after microneedling. So this means avoiding products with preservatives, fragrances, AHAs and BHAs. So when I talk about AHA, it's like glycolic acid, mandelic acid. These are great to use when it comes to fading hyperpigmentation, but you want to use it before you microneedle. I highly recommend you use the Banish Pumpkin Mask before microneedling. Okay, so I'm currently in the bathroom right now because I'm moving and I don't know where else to be in this house right now, so sorry if it's echoing. So I have the Banish Pumpkin Mask with me right now. It's a little bit dark, but I'm gonna use it all today. If I was to microneedle, I'm not gonna do it after, I'm gonna do it before, okay? So I've already cleansed my skin. I'm gonna put it all over my cheeks to help my hyperpigmentation fade. And this makes a world of a difference. If you use it after your microneedling session, your skin is going to be further irritated and it will sting. Do not do that. And when I talk about BHA, this is talking about like salicylic acid. So if you're using topical treatments for your acne, make sure you're using it before your microneedle, or at least wait 2 to 3 days until your skin recovers. Mistake number four is taking medication while dermarolling. So this is a really serious topic, and I hope you guys listen to this carefully, because some drugs out there, such as antibiotics and Roaccutane, cause sun sensitivity, hypersensitive skin, and sometimes it also prevents your skin from healing properly. So if you're on Roaccutane or have taken Roaccutane, make sure you wait at least 6 months to 12 months for your skin to heal and go back to its normal state in order to treat your scars by using microneedling tools. Mistake number 5 is starting the next microneedling session even before your skin heals. Because I know personally, I used to be super impatient when it comes to treating my scars, and even though I knew my skin was quite sensitive, I'll like continue the next microneedling session because I thought the more I do it, the faster the results that I'll get. But that's not the case, and it's definitely untrue. So really gauge how your skin reacts when it comes to microneedling. So with the Banish roller, with the 0.5 millimeters, you'll do it once every 2 weeks. But with the stamp, with the updated Banisher 2.0, you'll do it once a week. But if, for example, your skin is still sensitive after like a week, make sure you give yourself a few more days. Don't rush the process, because it's really important when it comes to treating your scars that you're patient and you're giving yourself time to heal. Mistake number 6. Is incorrectly cleaning your Banisher. So again, I'm speaking from personal experience. I have a disinfectant spray, and pretty much I used to just spray my Banisher 2.0, and I was like, yep, that would do. you know, they'll clean it thoroughly. And I knew that was wrong and I stopped doing that a long time ago. Thank God. Spraying it is not good enough. Using boiling water, definitely avoid that. Please, there is a lid for a reason. You fill the lid with rubbing alcohol to the line, twist on the cap, and make sure you leave it on there for 5 to 10 minutes for it to thoroughly clean and disinfect the needles. So yeah, after disinfecting it, make sure you let it dry and then you can use it onto your skin. Mistake number 7, stamping with bent needles. Examine your tool really, really carefully. Is it bent or is it straight? Because you don't want to further damage your skin. So if they are bent, chuck it in the bin, don't use it. Buy a new one. So with the Banisher 2.0, after 8 to 10 uses, you want to chuck it in the bin because over time the needles will bend. This is with all microneedling tools. I have received comments in the past saying, oh my god, that's such a waste, or oh my god, that's so expensive. But the reality is, that's the nature of microneedling tools. With microneedling tools, after you use it for a certain time, it will bend. This is unpreventable, this is unavoidable, and that's just how it is. Sometimes treating our skin is expensive, sometimes it's costly, and I'm sorry to tell you this, but I would rather spend money and invest on proper needles than trying to save money and using bent needles into my skin, only further causing irritation, causing more damage, causing more scars onto my face. That's why this point is really important, and I hope you guys realize this, that changing your microneedling tools is really important. Do not stamp your skin with bent needles just to save money. It is not worth it. Mistake number 8. Last but not least, the lack of consistency. So for example, if you are using the microneedling tool once at the beginning of June, and then you give yourself 3 weeks or 4 weeks or, you know, 2 months, and then you microneedle again. Like, there is the lack of consistency is not going to give you the results. Don't do it too often and don't neglect your skin for too long. So that's it for today's video. I hope you really enjoyed it and found it helpful. I did these mistakes in the past, but hopefully this video prevents you from doing any more of those mistakes. If you have any questions or you want to share your experience, definitely comment down below. I love reading them and I love replying to them. If you also want to find me on my other social medias, check out PrettyProgress23. It means the world to me to receive your support and love. And yeah, I hope you guys have a wonderful day, and I'm sending you all my love and light. Mwah. Bye.